हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज़ गुरवीन कौर। आई एम लेक्चरर एट प्रवीण पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ डिप्लोमा इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद चैप्टर नंबर 4, दैट इज़ एनवायरमेंटल पॉल्यूशन। एंड द टॉपिक विच वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस चैप्टर इज एयर पॉल्यूशन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद इट। सो वॉट बेसिकली एन एयर पॉल्यूशन इज, वी कैन से दैट इट इज़ अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ केमिकल्स, पर्टिकुलेट मैटर और बायोलॉजिकल मटेरियल्स दैट कॉजेज हार्म टू ह्यूमंस एज वेल एज अदर ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच आर लिविंग इन द एनवायरमेंट। दे आर बेसिकली स्पॉइलिंग द नेचुरल एनवायरमेंट। ओके, इन सिंपल वर्ड्स वी कैन से दीज द सर्टन सब्सटेंसेज आर प्रेजेंट इन द एटमोसफियर विच वेन इनहेल्ड दे आर वेरी हार्मफुल एंड डेंजरस फॉर द हेल्थ of the people or the health of the living beings, and on inhaling it can cause severe damages to the body, to the climate and vegetables. Everything have a very bad impact if contaminated or a harmful substance get mixed up in the air. Okay, and the presence of one or more contaminants like dust, smoke, mist, odor in the atmosphere which are injurious for the human beings, plants and animals, that thing should be minimized. So this is what basically an air pollution is all about. Now there are many sources of air pollutants or which causes air pollution, so we'll have a look over there. So before that, what basically a pollutant is, I just want to share. You can say that it is a substance which is in the air that can cause harm to the environment, and it can be in the form of solid particles, it can be in the form of liquid droplets, or in the form of gaseous state. Any state this substance can cause harm, and these pollutants are classified as primary and secondary. The primary pollutants are directly emitted from a process such as ash or volcanic eruptions, and the secondary are, you can say, not directly emitted. They form in the air when primary pollutants react or interact with other pollutants. So when this two-level interaction takes place, at that time secondary pollutants are formed. So let's have a look of the pollutants over here. Certain pollutants are mentioned, what are their sources, and each sources has a certain effect, even that thing is mentioned. So let's start. The first one is the carbon monoxide. Now the nature of carbon monoxide is, it is colorless, odorless, poisonous gas. Okay, it is formed when there is combustion of fossil fuels, and when this combustion process is not completed, at that time this type of pollutant is released and it gets mixed up in the air. You can say this is very harmful. Why? Because when the incomplete combustion, the air which is released from this incomplete combustion, it is harmful. And what are the sources? Due to cigarette smoking, due to again incomplete burning of the fuels, and also the motors which are having that gas is the source. Health effects can be headache, nausea, then anemia, coma, irreversible brain cells. You all know, even the brain get damaged due to when it comes to contact with this type of substance. Second one is nitrogen dioxide. Okay, it is a reddish brown gas, and it gives photochemical smog. Smog means a foggy texture it usually gives. This is created when fuels are burned in the vehicles or from industrial plants, and when inhaled it causes lung irritation and lung damage. Second one is sulfur dioxide, SO2. Again, this is a colorless gas which is formed during the combustion of coal and oil, and it gets converted into sulfuric acid. This is formed as it is formed due to combustion of coal and oil. In the sources will be coal and also all the industrial processes. Due to this, asthma problems many people faces asthma problems. Then suspended particulate matter. Now these are, you know, aerosols. These are certain particles and droplets. When the burning of coal in the industries or diesel in the vehicles, agricultural unpaved roads. There are agriculture is there, then unpaved roads. All these things happens at that time. This SPM is generated and it causes irritation in the nose, throat. It causes lung damage, bronchitis, asthma, cancer. Ozone, O3, ozone layer, we know that is also plays a very important role, and if this does not exist, then skin cancer is the major problem, you can say. Over here, when highly reactive, it has a highly reactive, irritating and unpleasant odor. Okay, and the major chemical over here is photochemical smog. I will explain you all what is a photochemical smog. Photochemical smog, you can say it is a combination, first of all. It is a combined word, and this combined word is of fog and smoke. When fog and smoke, this both the things they combine, it leads to smog. This is a word and it is called as portmanteau. Portmanteau is a, you know, like a dictionary of words where two or three words are combined. When smoke and fog is combined, it leads to photochemical smog. So these are also very dangerous. They are brown in color, and they are generated due to automobile traffic. All the work which is done in the automobile factories at that time, this type of chemical is released, and due to this breathing problems, their cough, eye, nose, throat irritation, heart disease, all it leads to all this thing. Lead, we know it is a very toxic material, and when inhaled, it can have very serious issues like brain and nervous system gets damaged. We get mental retardation in children, and also digestive problems are there. It causes cancer. Lead is usually found in paint colors. Then lead manufacturing companies are also has this smell around that area, which causes, you know, problem for that people staying in that area. Storage batteries having all these things. So these are, you know, are sources, and each source have certain effect on the livelihood of the people. There are chances of many people who becomes prone to cancer. It has a very bad impact on children because the growth of the children is, you know, not proper. If they live in the cities which are highly exposure to air pollutants, they develop asthma, pneumonia, lower respiratory infections are, you know, developed. And even the mothers, those who are pregnant mothers or girls, okay, they have very low birth rate. The birth rate goes very down. People cannot get pregnant due to all this air pollutants, because it is inhaled and it damages the, you know, uterus of a woman. These are very bad impact which air pollutants has on the environment. Cardiovascular health is also important, and even this it becomes a threat. Now prevention and control. Prevention and control also plays a very important role. These are certain points given over here which on our level we can do. Like we can conserve energy at our home, at our work, everywhere. Means if suppose there is no need of extra light or fan, then we should turn it off. Then energy star labels are available. We know that certain nationalized standards are there, and if that like ISO, WHO, that standards, they are a proof, or you can say trust, which people, it becomes easy for the people to buy the product. Okay, so we should make sure that these Energy Star labels are there on all the equipment which we are using for our home or for our office, so they are pollution free and it can cause no harm. Okay, then make use of public transportation. We are using public transportation. Okay, if we use our own car, or each person in the house is having its own car, so what will happen? It will contribute to the air pollution. It's better to use public transportation so the traffic is less, and if not, then it's better to walk. Okay, then you can see many gasoline products are there. We can purchase that types of product which are easy. Okay, and next point you can say, our tires are properly inflated. Why? Because even tires create a type of pollution. Then we can make use of paint which does not contain lead. The smell of that is a very bad if has very bad effect on the people who comes in contact with that. And also the cleaning product should be lead free. Over here many more points are given. We can make use of a fireplace. Reduce the use of this type of fireplaces. People are using fireplaces, so it's better because the wood we burn, it again causes pollution. Burning of leaves, trash, other materials causes air pollution, so we should avoid that. We should again avoid using the automobile products. So these were the certain points. You can go through all the points which we can do at our level. This type of control measurements can be done at human level. We does not require any special expertise in this area. This can be done on our level. Now over here, these are the ambient air quality standards. Now ambient air quality standard is in each section in this chapter. We are having certain standards which are provided by the government, so that if a particular pollutant or particular gas is extend its level, it can become dangerous. So these are in ambient air quality standards, the concentration of pollutants in the air are checked, and it basically refers to the outdoor air. The outdoor air of a particular area is checked, that what concentration exists, what materials or substance exist in that air, and what effects it can have on the people living in that surrounding area. So here certain examples are given, like sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide, 1 hour consumption is okay. A total highly concentration of 1 hour is okay, but if it exceeds, then it becomes very difficult. It will create problems. Then there are particulate matters, fine particulate matters. All these points are given. Averaging time is given over here, 24 hour, and this should not be exceeded more than once in a year. If it exceeds its limit, again these points are going to, this pollutants are going to create heavy pollution and has ill effects on the environment. Carbon monoxide is there, limit is given 1 hour. Okay, then again there are two types over here, and in different areas. For natural, you can say it is 1 hour, and if it is generated through factories or something, 8 hours are given. Ozone concentration is also given. It is divided into primary and secondary. 1 hour is there, and other level is 8 hours. So the concentration, whatever R is given, it should not exceed that amount. Nitrogen oxide, again, if it is on the basic normal level, annual is okay, daily consumption is okay, but for highly concentrated areas, for where the chemicals are very more, that 1 hour consumption is also very harmful. Lead also rolling 3 months, means the amount of time is given is consumption 3 months is okay. It should not be exceeded from that, means continuous consumption I am talking over here, not more than that. So these were certain standards, and just it is a government go through analysis. We have not to do anything with this, only standards, and each pollutant is having a time limit, and when that time limit exceed, it becomes very harmful. So over here certain range is given, and this range we don't need to be it don't need to be taken care of. The government only takes care of that.